Hi everyone, I am Dr. Sakshi Arora Hans, your OBGY faculty at Maro, and unexpectedly the FMG results are declared and I am so happy to share the screen with Dr. Siddharth, who has not just cleared the exam but he has scored 243. What an amazing score, Dr. Siddharth. Congratulations.
Thank you, ma'am. It is all because of you. I saw your videos so many times.
Oh, that is so humble of you to say that. But before you give the credit to me, I would want you to tell our viewers, all your colleagues and your juniors, more about yourself.
Okay, so I'm Dr. Siddharth. I'm graduated from Kyiv Medical University, Ukraine. Okay. I joined in 2018 and I graduated like this year only in February. I graduated.
So this was your first attempt?
Yeah, this was my first attempt.
First attempt, and you have literally smashed it. How
Thank
did you
ma'am.
Manage that? Tell me, are you a Maro Plan C user or a Plan B user?
No, I've been using my Plan C from like 2020 or 2021.
And who introduced you to Maro? How did you come to know about Maro?
My seniors, ma'am. They told me about that. I have some friends who are preparing for NEET PG, so they told me about it. Yeah.
And then you started your journey with Maro. How was your journey with Maro, and how much what did you watch? Did you watch all the videos in Maro, or were you very selective with subjects or selective with videos? What was your strategy?
I started with medicine. I actually watched all the videos of Maro, like the main videos. Almost all subjects, especially in the final year and pre-final year, I watched all of them.
So when you were watching the videos, like most of the FMG students and even the IMG students, they complain that when we are watching, we are unable to make notes and it's too lengthy. You didn't feel anything like that?
No, because I started very early. So I watched the videos. Then I went on to read the main books. Like for medicine, I used Harrison's, for surgery, Belly and Love. For OBGY, I used Datta. So I watched the videos, then I read the book. After that, only I made my own notes. So that was the strategy I used. Because I had a lot of.
You were watching Maro videos and then you were reading the main textbooks also.
Yes, ma'am.
Right?
Watching the videos actually made it easy to read the book.
That is what I wanted to ask you next. Yeah. That once you watch the videos and then you went to textbooks like Harrison, like Belly and Love, how did you find reading Harrison and Belly and Love after watching the videos?
It was really easy, ma'am, because I knew what to focus on. Because the books are very big, so you cannot complete the whole book. So after watching the videos, you know what to read and what to not to read.
So approximately, Dr. Siddharth, how much time did you take to watch all the medicine, surgery, OBGY videos?
Like 2 years, ma'am. Like to complete the whole syllabus, I pre-final and final year, I took 2 years.
Pre-final and final, you took 2 years.
Yes,
but approximately, can you tell that if someone starts, how much time will it take to watch these videos of final year, approximately?
Ma'am, I think they can do it in 6-7 months.
Because I used to study
4 to 5 hours I used to give, but if one person is giving like 8 to 10 hours, they can do it in seven, 8 months max, the whole videos.
And when you were watching the videos, were you also doing MCQs side by side?
In the beginning, no, but after I started grabbing the concepts, I started doing the MCQs.
See, now I wanted to know, because there are many FMG students who feel that watching main videos is going to take a time, it will be, and they will not be able to revise. But here I have Dr. Siddharth sitting in front of me, who not only did the main videos, but how did you plan your revision then?
The revision, actually, I planned like 7 to 8 revisions in the last 6 months.
7 to 8 revisions?
Yeah.
And that's why you are sitting here.
Yeah, the main strategy was to revise the whole 19 subjects in the last week. That was the game changer, because you cannot remember everything. So So you have to revise everything in the last 7 to 10 days. Otherwise, you will forget in the exam.
So you did volatile subjects in the last 1 week. But
yeah, like anatomy and...
I'll just ask a little bit more in detail because there will be so many viewers who would be listening to you and following your strategy. There, because you are an inspiration for so many, right? So tell me that when you did the main videos and then you started revising, did you revise from the notes of the main videos or did you do the revision videos at that time?
No, I had made my own notes. So I did revise from that. But every time I used to highlight something or highlight the main points. So that when I revise once again, I have to focus on that only. Not the things I already remember.
You were filtering out the content with every revision.
Yeah.
Okay. And when did you start giving GTs?
I started in November last year.
Last year, November. And how many GTs did you give?
In total, I think 60 to 70.
60 to 70 GTs. So how frequently were you giving GTs?
I think 2 every week.
That's amazing. Now, after giving a GT, how were you reviewing it? Were you reviewing only the incorrect answers or were you reviewing all the 300 questions?
No, I just reviewed only the incorrect answers.
Only the incorrect answers.
Yeah.
Again, Dr. Siddharth, I would like to know over here, like you said that later on you started practicing MCQs. So were you practicing MCQs of the NEET PGQ bank or the FMGQ bank?
I started with NEET PG, but in the last 2 months, I did the FMG only. Even GT, I gave
NEET PG. How many modules were you able to complete NEET PGQ bank?
I think I completed almost 70 to 80%. I completed the NEET PG part.
Acha. While you were completing those MCQs, were you bookmarking the difficult ones and did you revisit them?
I was not able to revisit all of them, but yeah, I did revisit some of them.
Okay, fine. And like you said that towards the end, you revised only the volatile subjects. So did you make any 20th notebook or did you use the Marrow Pearls for that purpose?
No, I did make the 20th notebook.
You made 20th.
Yeah.
And did you use Marrow Pearls also, Beta?
No, not really.
Actually, you didn't use it. Which was that one feature of Marrow, which you found the most helpful feature?
The custom module. I used to do that 100 every day in the morning and 100 every day before sleep.
Okay, so you made your own MCQ tests, like the custom modules. So what generally students, they keep on asking me that, ma'am, what tags to use for custom modules? So generally, which tags did you use for custom modules?
Like when in the initial phase, you can use all the tags. But towards the end, you have to use recent FMG, recent NEET PG and INICT.
I don't know whether recent FMG is there or not. Yes, recent NEET PG and AIMS is there. So definitely that has to be used. When you were doing near the exam, did you do PYQs, PYTs of FMG or did you do NEET PG as well?
No. I did PYQs of FMG last 10 years. NEET PG, I did 6 to 8 years and INICT, I did 3 years.
Wonderful.
And surprisingly, that also helped.
Yes, you didn't leave any stone unturned. So once you were writing the exam, how were you feeling about paper 1 and paper 2?
Paper 1 was actually easy. But paper 2, the first 50 questions, unfortunately for me, it went very bad. Because I think this time surgery was a bit difficult.
Yes, that was for
everyone. Yeah, I had all the surgery questions in the first part. But then I did the second and third part, I was good.
Okay. Did you give the FMG national mock test also at Marrow?
Yeah, I did that.
So what was your marks there? How much did you score?
I think I scored 235 or 236. I don't remember exactly, but yeah.
So that is reflective of your reflective, you know, just now you've got 243, there you got 236. Wonderful. Awesome. And your scores have been consistent throughout. What were your scores of GT?
Like it has been between 240 to 270. It has been between that only.
So since you said that you watched all the videos of Marrow, were there any faculties who in specifically, you know, influenced you and helped you achieve this score?
Ma'am, obviously you were there, Rohan sir, obviously. But someone who I really admire is Rakesh sir. I started with these videos only, medicine. Even Abbas sir.
Yes. Yeah. So Rakesh sir, Dr. Abbas, Dr. Rohan, all of them, they are legendary and they have their own style of teaching and they are best at it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So do you have any message for all those students who couldn't clear this time? Any tip which you would like to give to them?
It's okay if you didn't clear this time. Just you have to focus on the PYTs, because this time and even the previous exams, topics are repeated. It's the game is in the options, because sometimes the options are confusing. But if you have to clear the concepts and repeat the same topics again and again, because they will be asked the same thing again and again.
Yes, so, and that is what I keep on telling to all the FMG students, that beta, this exam, the approach for this exam has to be a very funnel approach, where they are going to ask you the same topics, but anything can be asked from that topic. So you don't have to focus on PYQs, you have to focus on PYTs, and that is what makes you not only clear the exam, but get a very good rank or a very good score. So thank you so much, Dr. Siddharth. You know, talking to you, I can see that your vision is so clear and you are not only going to do well in NEET PG, but you are also going to do well in your life. God bless you, beta, and enjoy your night today.
Thank you, ma'am.
Take care.